অলক দা,
হ্যাঁ বলুন।
বলি টাইম কত হচ্ছে? আমার দুটো মোবাইলে দুটো দুরকম দেখাচ্ছে, একটা 9:59 আর একটা দেখছে 9:56।
হ্যাঁ 56,
হ্যাঁ, কত টাইমটা কোনটা ঠিক?
9:56,
নাইন
নাইন
ফিফটি
ফিফটি
সিক্স
সিক্স
ওকে 9:56 ওকে, উই হ্যাভ টু ওয়েট ফর অ্যানাদার 4 মিনিটস। ওকে,
বলুন বলুন।
হ্যাঁ না ঠিক আছে, ওকে, টাইম রিগার্ডিং দ্য টাইম।
গুড মর্নিং এভরিবডি। নাও
ওকে ম্যাডাম, ম্যাডাম আই ক্যান স্টার্ট, দেন ইউ ক্যান স্টার্ট,
ওকে ওকে
ওকে আফটার,
ওকে ওকে
ওকে
ওকে
আই গিভ সাম ইন্ট্রোডাকশন টু ইউ, দেন ইউ ক্যান স্টার্ট, ওকে। গুড
ওকে
মর্নিং ডিয়ার স্টুডেন্ট, গুড মর্নিং টু ফ্যাকাল্টি অ্যান্ড স্টাফ মেম্বার। টুডে ইজ দ্য ফিফথ ডে, দ্যাট ইজ দ্য লাস্ট ডে অফ দিস 5-ডে ইন্ডাকশন প্রোগ্রাম। আই থিঙ্ক এভরিবডি এনজয় দ্য সেশনস অফ দিস 5-ডে ইন্ডাকশন প্রোগ্রাম। টুডে ফার্স্ট সেশন উইল বি টেকেন বাই প্রফেসর সেবা মাইতি, হু ইজ ওয়ার্কিং এজ অ্যাসিস্ট্যান্ট প্রফেসর ইন দি ডিপার্টমেন্ট অফ ইলেকট্রনিক্স অ্যান্ড কমিউনিকেশন ইঞ্জিনিয়ারিং ডিপার্টমেন্ট। ডক্টর মাইতি জয়েন্ড দিস ইনস্টিটিউট ইন 9th January 2006। ন্যাশনাল সার্ভিস স্কিম, পপুলারলি নোন এজ NSS, ইজ অ্যান এক্সটেনশন অফ এ অ্যাক্টিভিটি টু দি হায়ার এডুকেশন সিস্টেম টু ওরিয়েন্ট দ্য স্টুডেন্ট ইউথ টু কমিউনিটি সার্ভিস হোয়াইল দে আর স্টাডিং ইন এডুকেশন ইনস্টিটিউট আন্ডার দি এজিসেস অফ মিনিস্ট্রি অফ Youth Affairs and Sports, Government of India. She tell you details about NSS activity in your college. Now over to Dr. Maiti to continue the sessions.
Thank you, sir. Welcome to all. Now I will present the NSS. NSS full form is National Service Scheme, and it is a government program. At first, I show you some presentation, and from here you get idea, clear idea. The NSS, National Service Scheme, it is a government program, and this government program, it is public service program conducted by the Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports of Government of India, popularly known as NSS. Every year, NSS Day is observed on September 24 across India. The National Service Program was launched in 1969, the birth centenary year of Mahatma Gandhi, in 37 universities involving 40,000 students. Now, I am present a video from where we get the clear idea what is the activity of NSS. No sound.
हे समाज के लिए उठे उठे, जगे स्वराष्ट्र के लिए जगे जगे, स्वयं सजे वसुंधरा सवार दे, स्वयं सजे वसुंधरा सवार दे। हम उठे उठे गजब हमारे संग साथियों, हम बड़े तो सब बढ़ेंगे अपने आप साथियों। सभी पे आसमान को उतार दे, सभी पे आसमान को उतार दे,
सजे वसुंधरा सवार दे,
सजे वसुंधरा सवार दे।
सजे ये जाके घर न बोलिया बने न शूल राहती लड़ाय बेल प्रेम की पतंगता की चाहती सद्भावना से ये चमन निखार दे सद्भावना से ये चमन निखार दे सदैव सुंदरा सवार दे समाज के लिए उठे उठे जगे स्वराष्ट्र के लिए जगे जगे स्वयं सचेव सुंदरा सवार दे स्वयं सचेव सुंदरा सवार दे
स्वयं सचेव सुंदरा सवार दे
नाउ व्हाट डज एनएसएस मींस The National Service Scheme is a central sector scheme of Government of India, Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports. Now, what do we do in NSS? NSS volunteers generally works in villages, slums and voluntary agencies to complete 120 hours of regular activities during an academic year. As per the fundamental principle of National Service Scheme, a volunteer is expected to remain in constant touch with the community. How can we join the NSS? Students can join the NSS scheme by registering themselves via the concerned program official. However, they must be of a bona fide university, college or school. The NSS is a voluntary scheme and students can enroll themselves from 11th standard onwards. What is NSS and its benefits? National Service Scheme is a beneficial of both students as well as the society in the various different means. NSS helps the students to grow individually and also as a group. It makes the students confident, develop leadership skill, and gain knowledge about different people from different walks of life. Some important NSS day throughout the year. From January 1 to 7, the Road Safety Week. January 12, the Youth Day, which is the birthday of Swami Vivekananda. January 25th, the National Volunteers Day, Voters Day, sorry. January 26th, Republic Day, January 30th, January, Anti-Terrorism Day, 8th March, International Women's Day, 7th April, World Health Day, May 21st, Anti-Terrorism Day, 31st March, World No Tobacco Day, 5th June, World Environment Day, 26th June, International Day Against Drug Abuse. July 8 to 14, International Literacy Week. 11th July, World Population Day. August 1 to 7, Feeding Day, Feeding Week. August 15th August, Independence Day. 20th August, Sadbhavna Divas. 5th September, everybody knows, Teachers Day. 8th September, International Literacy Day. 15th September, International Peace Day. And 24th September is the NSS Day. 1st October, National Blood Donation Day. 2nd October, Gandhi Jayanti. Communal Harmony Day also. 11th October, World Sight Day. 19th November, National Integration Day. 1st December, World AIDS Day. 7th December, Armed Force Flag Day. 10th December, World Human Rights Day. We organized several activities or programs in our college in previous years. Now I am showing some photograph. We are celebrating in our college campus. We are celebrating the Martyrs' Days on 30th January 2020. We also organized some blood donation camp also with here, and huge number of students and staff members, even our directors also donate the blood. And water is a very important and essential thing. So we stop wasting water program and keep our environment clean in our campus. And stop the pollution air. For that, we need to plantation. Plantation is very, very important. So we need to plantation, and which can protect the in pollution, control our pollution in our environment, and we save our environment and save our world. Now, so though the NSS is a government program, it needs involvement of us, that is common people, particularly the youth and students. Our institutes and students are actively involved in several NSS programs. I expect and appeal the newcomer students will also join this scheme. With respect to our institute, we may take NSS scheme as our campus is very close to thermal power plant, which continuously emitting heat, dust, and black smoke. To some measures, we need to stress on plantation. If each one of you at least plant one during 4 years, this will contribute a lot. Not only that, here in this plantation, in our university curriculum structure, there is one marks, mandatory additional requirement. So if you plant things on the tree, some marks will be added there. If we'll do the NSS activity, all are also be involved with our marks. Okay, so we get the marks. Blood donation, plantation tree, and any other social activity, all there are some marks which are added in our marks. Nearly in our campus, college campus, there are villages living poor people. The children suffer from several health related problems and also do not have scope of education. So we may set up a literacy center and run in weekend to educate all illiterate people as well as the school left boys and girls. Except that we may arrange some fundraising program to help these poor people and needy people. We may keep involved to clean our campus at least every 15 days and several many other programs, say, we may arrange. Finally, I once again welcome to you to this institute. You will be regular and sincere, and you must be disciplined. You will make your academic journey successful and uphold the institute glory. Wish you all the best. Thank you. Now, if you have any query, you may ask.
Thank you, ma'am, for your nice presentations and nice knowledge you share with the student. This will enrich their knowledge. and if they wish, they can participate in NSS program. Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Now, PC Ghosh, sir. Is it audible?
Yeah, you are audible, but very feeble voice coming out. Am I clearly audible?
Yeah, clearly audible. You are clearly. Okay. Very now, feeble. Our next session will be okay. Just I introduce you, then you can start the session.
Okay.
And our second session will be taken by Mr. Prabhas Chandra Ghosh. In the short form, everybody know him as a PC Ghosh. He is one of the key personnel in this institute who look after the placement in this college. Not only the placement, but also arrange different program, soft skill, aptitude, grooming, etc. so that students are ready for placement. He also arrange different technical program from industry personnel. He will guide you for your different industrial training. Now I request Mr. PC Ghosh to continue the sessions. Sir.
Okay, thank you so much, DG sir. Thank you. Good morning, everybody. Hope you are all safe and doing well. Myself, as DG sir told, myself, PC Ghosh, training and placement officer from this college. I'm working in this as TPO. For the last 15 years, I have joined January 2006, looking after all these things. And my colleague is not there today, Mr. Pradeep Mallick. He helps me, he's assistant TPO. This Mr. Mallick and myself look after the training and placement activities of this college as almost since beginning. Mr. Mallick joined in 2001 and I joined in 2006. Anyway, what I'll do, I will just give you a brief glimpse of activities and placement cell of this CM Kolaghat. So anyway, I just read out something. You just listen to it. If you have any question, you can interrupt me and can ask question. Otherwise, you can ask questions at the end of my speech. So training and placement is very important department of any college. There are 10,000 engineering colleges in India. Here, 2.7 million means 27 lakhs engineers are coming out of the college, degree engineers throughout India. And how many jobs are there? There are only 6 lakhs jobs are there. Out of them, 5 lakhs in the 1 lakh in the core sector. Students are there, almost 3 million, means 30 lakh students are there. That means 1% in 5 will get a job. That's one of the very difficult, and it's a huge challenge for any training and placement and for the students also to cope up with this kind of magnitude of problem. And also, as per NASCOM, do you know NASCOM? NASCOM is National Association of Computer Computer and Software Companies. National Association of Computer and Software Companies, NASCOM. They regulate and monitor all the activities regarding the software companies in India. There are so many software companies, and most of them are members of the NASCOM. And as per NASCOM, it is only 27% engineers who are passing out every year from the degree engineering colleges are employable. Means 73% students are not employable. What does it mean by employable? Employable means who are industry ready. Out of the college, they are more or less industry ready, and they have to they are employable. They can be given job and they can do the job properly and they can sustain for their life. But this figure is also very shocking. It's only 27%. That's why there are so many things you have to do. I'll just glimpse through the activities of the training and placement cell to start with. I'll tell you what is the vision of the college. Vision of the college is pursuing excellence in teaching learning to produce high quality engineering professionals. This is the vision of CEM Kolaghat. What are the missions? Missions are to enhance the employability of our students by imparting high quality technical and professional education. Improvement in monitoring of students' performance as per the expectation of various stakeholders. And the stakeholders are the students, the guardians, the faculty members, the industry, all of them are stakeholders. Industry cannot run if they don't get suitable person or students who are passing out of the college. Industry will ruin. And if the students don't get a job, they are also on the same path. There is nothing more to do after passing out. That's why this is one of the mission. What is the second mission? To continuously update as well as broaden the knowledge base, along with promoting a culture of research for achieving excellence. This is the second mission of the college. What are the selection process? When any MNCs or small, big, core, software, whatever is that, when any company comes to our college for campus recruitment, they generally follow the following four steps. First step, shortlisting of the students as per company criteria. It is to be noted that is not always true, but most of the big MNCs, they require 60% marks all through. 60% marks all through means 60% in 10th, 60% in 12th, and 60% in BTEC. This one of the criteria is not always true. There are so many companies, they don't look up at the marks criteria. They tell that some students might have got bad marks, but they are really good students. And some company insist on this, that this is one of the screening criteria. Then what is the second step? After the students are shortlisted, there will be an aptitude and technical test. It might be written or online. What is the second step? It's aptitude and technical test. What is aptitude? Aptitude consists of your logical reasoning, numerical ability, your verbal knowledge in verbal means knowledge in English, and coding. Your technical test means coding efficiency. All these things are looked after, and this is the first hurdle. If you want to get a job, you have to pass this, you have to cross this first hurdle. Unless and until you clear the aptitude or initial technical test, you won't be called for interview. And this is the end of your path or chance of getting selected if you don't clear the aptitude test. This is the second test. Then what is the third step is the group discussion. Group, mainly IT companies don't go for group discussion usually. This group discussion is more used by the core sector companies. Only mainly core sector companies go for the group discussion. And then the fourth step is technical interview. If you clear the aptitude test, and then if you clear the group discussion part, sometimes not required, then comes the technical interview part. Technical interview, what do they check? They check the technical competence of the students who are going to face the interview, whether they're technically competent or not. But there should not be any worry to this thing, that technical, if you don't or cannot answer the technical test, sometimes it is not taken as very negative things. Because whatever you are studying now, after 3 years when you will be facing the interview, then these subjects are going to be more or less obsolete. Then They just check whether you are ready or whether you adapt to the learning process of the particular company. Because what you are studying now, it will be obsolete when you join any particular company if you get selected. That's why they just check the learning ability, the adaptability of the person in a, to work in a team, and other basic competence, and some is most in most of the cases for core sector companies also, everywhere coding part is in included. That means even if you are an electrical or mechanical student, you have to have some basic knowledge in coding. But what is generally expected from the CSITC students, they do the coding part very well. They study almost 3 years the coding. But in electrical and mechanical engineers, the students, they don't have too much knowledge of coding. That's why I advise all of you, when you, the coding part is there in the first semester itself, any student, whether from CS or mechanical, you just attend the coding classes properly and keep a practice on coding, so that at the end of 3 years, when the campuses start for your batch, you could remember or just could run some programming. You don't have to be a pandit, expert in this, just a basic coding idea. And it is more or less universal for any stream, anywhere in India. Coding part is included everywhere, because nowadays machine learning, robotics, the Python, that artificial intelligence, these are also used by anybody, starting from mechanical, from computer science, IT, even for the general MSc students, they're also doing this coding part. That's why coding is very essential nowadays. And then the next step after technical interview is the HR interview. HR means human resource interview. There they check the mental setup of the student, that the attitude and aptitude of the student, whether they are able to learn new things, or they can, whether they can work in a team very happily and peacefully without making too much noise. These are the things are taken care of by HR interview. After these four steps of interviews, you are given, if you clear all these parts, all these steps, only then you are given offer letter. After offer letter, they'll give joining letter. Then you have to join at a particular date when the company tells you to do. These are the selection process. And as I was telling, that aptitude class is very important, because if you don't clear the aptitude test, you cannot or would not be able to get any job. That's the first hurdle for any student to get a job. Keeping this in mind, and the NASSCOM's employability of 27% survey for the last 6-7 years, what we are doing, we are giving CRT. What does it mean, CRT? CRT means campus recruitment training. These trainings are run all through the year from fifth semester onwards for all the students. Now the 2019-23 best students, they are undergoing this training. And just to make the students very much employable, and so that they can cross the hurdle of aptitude test. Aptitude test, for this, we have hired one external expert, one agency. Those who are expert in this kind of aptitude test or training, they have been hired, and they do it every, more or less every day of the week in different batches. Presently is going on for 2019-23. After 1.5 years, you will also get in the process the training of this. There you are taught like numerical ability, logical reasoning, verbal section, basic coding part, and they also group discussions, mock interviews, technical coding classes, these are also held under the CRT, campus recruitment training. And also company specific test. if you know, I will tell you later, almost all the big companies recruit our students. And different companies have different set of questions for aptitude or technical part. For this, keeping this in mind, that our agency, Mr. Biswarup Chatterjee, Equity Training and Placement, he also takes the specific company specific mock test. Right, as for example, for Cognizant, last 5 year questions were collected and it is sent to the students to give the answers. This kind of Fortress is also done, for Infosys is also done. These type of mock tests are held very regularly to familiarize you with the question pattern of any specific company. This is the campus recruitment training. And for the last, I would like to mention, for the last 3-4 years, placement percentage of our students. 2015-2019 students, out of 100% students, 76.42% students have been placed through college campuses. For 2019 passing out batch, 76.42% is the placement statistics, placement percentage from this college. For 2016-2020, it is 78.42%. 78.42% for the students who have passed out in 2020. And for 2021 batch, due to the pandemic situation, other factors beyond our control, it has decreased a bit. Till now, 51% students have been placed so far for the 2021 pass out batch of students. And the interview is still going on, and it is in a very staggered manner, because for any campuses, the campuses are closed in 1 or 2 days time. But nowadays it's taking weeks to complete the process through virtual mode. And still that, till 51% so far students have been placed for 2021 batch. And 2018-22 batch, the process has started and is going to be held very soon. And if you go for this year, generally 75% to 80% students are placed through campus interview. It hovers around this figure, 75% to 80%. And it is true for the last 20 batches who have passed out. And sometimes with some exception like this, what is going on for 21 batch is 51%. I expect it to cross 60%, but it won't be in the margin of 75%. And otherwise, 2-3 exceptions are there in the last 20 years, but more or less 75 to 80% students are placed to the college campuses. Then one more thing you should know from the very first year, there is called hackathons. Hackathons means all the big corporate organizations conduct hackathons. Through these hackathons, students can get pre-placement offers, internship opportunities, much before the real campus season starts. You will be happy to note that already two students of our 2018-2022 batch, those who will pass out in 2022, 3-4 students have already been selected, few in Infosys and one in TCS, through these hackathons. Because this is an opportunity to get any job offer and before March, before than actual campus starts. For 2022 passing out batch, student, that campus season is going to start. TCS has taken the online test, others are going to take it very soon. But already 3 students have already been placed, and they are not worried about placement till yet. They are not concerned. They are just concentrating on their studies and to do well in the to get good marks in BTEC. That will help them in future. But other students also should take these things very seriously. There are a few names, to name a few hackathons like TCS Code Vita, Nginx, Infosys Hackwit Infy, InfyTQ Certification, Cognizant Hackathon, Google Hackathon, and so on. You will see whenever, when you are eligible, or when I think this is to be given to the first year students, I'll of course send you the details, that all these hackathons are giving you an opportunity to get placed much before the campus placement season starts. Then what are the companies come to our campuses? Who are the major recruiters? If name any software companies you name, most of them have taken our students. If you go through the placement percentage this year and in which companies they have been placed, you will get to see TCS, Infosys, HCL, IBM, Accenture, TCG Digital, Wipro, Mindtree, you name anything, every student of this 2021 passing out batch, most of them have been placed by these companies. But only thing is that some students, the number of students recruited for Infosys or Cognizant and TCS is a bit more. But other companies like Accenture, Mindtree, Wipro, they have taken 4, 5, 6 students like this. But to update you or to tell you that initially, when the college started campus placement season, initially the companies are used to come and they had taken hundreds of students. The highest number so far placed in any one drive is by Cognizant. 123 students were placed in Cognizant in one day. And for TCS, it is 122. And for Infosys, it was 86, the highest so far. But nowadays, the situation has changed, and we are not being able to motivate you to go through the campus recruitment trainings, to attend the classes sincerely, normal routine classes, so that your technical knowledge should be increased. And at the end of 3-4 years, you are employable and get a job offer in a very good company. Some students are very sincere, serious. And as of now, I can tell you, only 20% students can get jobs without any help. They can do it on their own. Whether TPO is there or training and preferential is there or not, whether jobs are very sparsely in different sectors, but still they will get job. But we are worried about 80% students who are not so much sincere and so much not motivated and have the lack of confidence. That's why we insist all of you, when you will get the opportunity to attend the CRT campus recruitment training, you must attend properly and sincerely so that you cross the hurdle of the aptitude test and get a chance to be selected through interviews. And for this reason, we have started these training programs and it's going on for a long time and is almost free of cost. And for course sector, as I told you, that for IT sector, the jobs out of 6 lakhs total jobs in the job market for the engineers in India, 5 lakhs are from the IT sector. And IT sector is recruiting, even in this pandemic situation, very large numbers. And only, but the course concern is for the core sector engineers. There are only 1 lakh job is available for the core sector engineers in India. That's why the competition is very huge. You have to be very sincere in your studies, whether it's in a classroom mode model, online model, whether it's normal technical course classes in the syllabi, or for the CRT. You must attend everything very sincerely and try to improve yourself for the next 3 years. Only then you will be able to get a good job in your hand. You have to give your best and the rest will take place automatically. Don't need to worry or don't need to be too concerned about all these things, but these are to be taken care of. These are in your hand what you can do to improve yourself, enhance your employability, and get selected in a good job. And this for the core sector, few companies' names are like this: Rishab Instruments, Rospi Group, Odisha Metallics Private Limited, MacMet, Jindal Steel, Atlas Copco is a very good company of Swedish multinational, Linde India, what is formerly known as BOC India Limited. But to be very honest and frankly with you, the core sector jobs are very few and far between. If we want to crack the core sector jobs, you have to really work hard. And if you work hard, you will quietly get a job, whether it's in IT sector or in core sector. One more point I would like to add with these activities, that you need to know the English very well. Why? Because the now it's a global village. Boundaries are going to be obsolete. Now you are in Kolaghat Indian College, after 3-4 years you get a job in a good company. You never know, within 3 months or 6 months you have to go to America, you have to work in New York, you have to go to Sydney, or you have to go to London, where you need to talk in English only. That's why English is very imperative, very essential to write correct English, to express your thoughts so that your communication is very clear to the clients, and you should understand their accent also. That's why English is very important. What you have to do, we are seeing for the last 10 years, this is the demographic profile of our students have changed. How it has changed? Initially, there are few colleges are there in West Bengal when we have started. Lot of students are coming from Kolkata and surrounding areas and having very good JE ranks and having English medium background. But for the last few years, the profile has changed. It is almost 85% to 90% students are from the rural background, having Bengali medium schooling, and this creates a problem. Only then, to address this, if you can write, speak, and read full good English, you won't have to bother about your job. I can tell you, I can guarantee you, if you can speak fluent English, you will get a job. This is so important, because now the English is a global language and the working boundaries are going to be obsolete. Now you are in Kolkata, next week you never know, you have to be in New York. Accordingly, you have to prepare yourself, and to get prepared, the first step is to know the English, how we can to improve your English communication. How we can do that? You can do that watching the news channels, English news channels. You can see the English movies. You read the English newspapers. You talk amongst your friends, teachers, and staff in English. This way, if you practice it for few weeks or few months, automatically that English part will improve. And that is very important. It is also true that we have a very good English department with efficient teachers, eminent teachers are there, but you have to utilize that also. Though it is not related with training and placement activities, I'll tell you about two other things what we do. We have industry incubation cell. You know, everywhere you can see in the media, print, electronic, whatever it is, a government of India and West Bengal wants to change the society to be an enterprising society. What does it mean by enterprising? Like Make in India, Atmanirbhar Bharat, all these are coming out from different channels, from different organizations, whether it's for central government or state government. And now they want to create good in the startup industry. For that, lot of things have to be have been given to improve this part, because some students have inherent quality for entrepreneurship and they want to be a job giver rather than a job seeker. Job giver means who gives jobs, and job seeker means who seeks jobs. Now we have to have a paradigm shift in our thinking. We need to think that I will start a company and I'll give jobs to the other students or other persons, and not to get a seek a job where you will be like an employee. You will be sitting in a cubicle and will ruin your whole life for this particular thing. Nowadays, this scenario has changed. Everybody is giving, whether it's state government or central government, they're even starting to fund also. If the project is good, there is venture capitalist. The government support is there. That's why we have created this industry incubation cell of this for this college, where members are from industry and academia are invited to interact with the students. Continuous workshop, mentoring, and talks by industry experts are held regularly. So far, not many, but few students opted for startups through our help and mentoring. Even we can organize, if you need some seed money for a particular idea to implement, you can approach us to arrange for seed money. We will try to give you the particular seed money from any venture capitalist or from the college itself. There is an NISP 2019, National Innovation and Startup Policy 2019. Government of India has launched this. So this particular thing, you can get help galore from any government, central or state government, all these things. So this is one area that you should also test or check or try. Even after trying, if you fail, we are there to help you. But if you try, if you get success, there will be no matching with any particular job. Job cannot give you that satisfaction if you can do something on your own. Then another part is there is Industry Institute Partnership Cell. IIPC was set up to increase the industry reach of our college. Members are there from industry and academia. Joint ventures for industry academia collaborations are looked after by the cell. Regularly, industry interactions are held through seminars, webinars, etc. Through these events, students come to know what are the industry expectations from them. You are a beginner, just started your engineering courses. You have to develop a lot. But if you want to get a job after 3 years of studies or after 4 years of studies, you have to know what industry wants from you. Only then you can try to improve yourself in that particular way and get selected in a particular job. That's why these industry interactions are held, to give you an idea of what the industry expects from any students who has applied for any particular job in that particular company. And industry inputs are sometimes also taken to improve the syllabus. And last but not the least, we will organize trainings for all the students after third semester, after fifth semester, to go for industrial training. That is also being organized by the training and placement cell. There, 100% students have to go for industrial training. But till for last year, it was after sixth semester. Now it has come down after in different slots. Like mechanical has got it in fifth semester. Electrical EC has got in the sixth semester. The evaluation will be seventh semester. And then CSIT have got their industrial training slot in seventh semester. And there is a 100 marks paper that there. You have to go for industrial training after this semester, as I have told. And the training and placement cell will help you all the way to go for these trainings. Whatever help is required, that will be given by the training and placement cell. So far, these are the activities of training and placement cell in brief. Now we will be interacting you with the next 4 years constantly regarding everything, and you can approach us to ask for any particular help at any time. and these are the things that I have to tell you for now. We will be instructing and telling you for the next 4 years about anything, everything, and we'll keep in touch with you. Wishing you all the best, I conclude. Over to DG sir. Do I have any question regarding this so far before I leave? Any student, any question? Any question? Any questions so far for any students?
Sir, I have a question.
One question chat box, sir. One question.
I have a question, sir.
No, 60% means generally. It's not that everybody has to have 60%, but sometimes big companies, they specify that you have to have 60% in 10th, 60% in 12th, and 6% in BTEC. But it's not mandatory for all the companies. You will get, even if you have less than 60% marks, you will get still ample opportunities you will be getting. And most of, lots of students are being placed without having the 60% marks. You don't need to worry. What you have to do, you have to properly study, concentrate your studies, try to improve yourself in all aspects. Automatically the job will come to, in your hand. Just what you have to do, you have to work hard. Nothing else. Nothing to worry about 60% things.
No, sir, I was just asking that the percentage of students placed in IT companies is 71% in 2 years back and 78% in last year. That is how what I am asking. Those students are placed through off campus or on campus?
No, to tell you, there are three types of campus individuals there. Number one is on campus. The company comes at a particular date to the college and recruits other students. That is on campus. Now is being yes, incident is almost the same. Now it's being held online only. But there's the on campus. Then there is another campus. Few colleges come together, or any particular company tells few colleges to organize a drive. That is called there. Few colleges are come together and organize the drive. That is called full campus drive. Off campus drive means the communication comes to the students through the training and placement cell, and training and placement cell informs the students that this is the off campus drive option. Right now, you apply. Then we apply, and the whole thing goes between the companies and the particular students. They are the role of training and placement cell as facilitator, or the media is obsolete. That's the job is for media, for the training and placement cell, and works as a medium between the students and the company. That's called off-campus drive. And that's what you wanted to know, no? And yes, almost yes. For on campus, we have generally Infosys, Cognizant, this year Hexaware. Otherwise, Wipro, Tech Mahindra, then Accenture, Mindtree, they also recruit, but they are not doing it through on campus basis. They are doing it a different names, they have got different programs. Like teachers used to come to our college, but they have stopped now because they're not going anywhere in India. Even not in IIT, they do, they take the NQT test, National Qualified Test. For the last 3 years, they're doing it. And you have to apply for NQT, and that you have to go through training and placement cell only. And you have to apply, you have to sit for online test, then the process moves on. Now they don't come to the college now. They don't go anywhere in India in any college. Now they're taking this centralized NQT, National Qualified Test.
Okay, sir. And sir, the internship, and what is the average students got internship?
What, you tell me again, the voice is coming very feeble.
Sir, the average students got internship in third year.
third year student, third, for internship, most of the students have done something or other, because in this pandemic situation, while we used to send the students like Holder Petrochemicals, Exide, like Indian Oil Corporation, Tata Chemicals, all these companies are not conducting internships right now. Everywhere, what is going on is through online mode, and that big the good companies where we used to send the students, we cannot send the students now because of the pandemic, because they are not taking any risk to bring students to their campus and get infected with coronavirus. That's why they have taken off from this event for the last 2 years. But there are so many internship opportunities there online. You can apply anywhere and you can get a job. You can get an internship. But to remind you, internship used to be a paid job, like a job. Before, even after 10 years back, when you go on to any particular company, you get paid some pocket money to sustain during the training period. But now it is the reverse. Sometimes, most of the cases, students don't need to pay. Sometimes the students need to pay for training or internship also. But all the students after third year have to go for internship, that's for sure. But that's only after third year. Even you can do training internship in first year, first semester also. But it's up to you, it's an optional. If you want to do something, you can do it on your own. If you want to do something, you need help from our training and presidential, we'll be very happy to help you. But that after third semester, third year, the training is mandatory as per the university syllabus. You have to go for training. But now you are in first semester now, is very new. I don't think it would be advisable to seek for internship at this point of time. Let's have the next semester onwards, you can try on your own or with the help of the training and presidential, you can try for internship.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Anything else?
Sir, is there any difference in between the BTEC honors and the only BTEC degree?
That DG sir or DKM sir would be the suitable person, competent person to answer. DG sir or DKM sir? DG sir, can you help me?
You please ask Dilip Gayan sir later on.
What is the difference between BTEC honors and BTEC?
Dilip Gayan sir will answer later on, because today we are running with short of time. Okay. You can call him or you can write a mail to DG sir. He will reply to you. Okay.
No, sir, I am asking, is there any difference to get a job in the placement in the interviews when I am only having BTEC degree and all BTEC honors degree?
Definitely difference is there. But I am suggesting you to write a mail to DG sir, because we are running with short of time. Okay. Definitely okay, difference is there. Because it is correct that in the BTEC honors, you have to earn few marks of NPTEL courses, MOOC courses. Na? So definitely it will help you. Okay. That can be discussed later on. Okay.
Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Then should I close my session?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Times are running out. Wishing all the students all the best. Have a fantastic 4 years of study in Kolaghat, working very hard and partying also very hard. Both things we have to have in balance. Only then you will be able to come out with flying colors from BTEC courses, and you can get a job in hand. And wishing you all the best, and thanking you all, DKM sir, DG sir, with respect, I conclude my session here. Over to DG and DKM sir. Please take care of the rest of the session, sir. Thank you so much.
DG sir, please.
Nah, DKM sir, actually, okay. Our next speaker is Professor Aditya Kumar Singh. Sir, are you joined?
Yeah, I am joined.
Sir, yes. Actually, he is the assistant professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering, Aditya Kumar Singh, actually tell you about the NCC in our college. Aditya sir, you can continue.
So is my slides visible?
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay. So good morning, everyone. I am Aditya Kumar Singh from Department of Mechanical Engineering. I am assistant professor as well as associate NCC officer of our college. So today I'm going to discuss or give you introduction about the NCC that do take place in our institute. So I hope everybody is aware with this NCC, which is National Cadet Corps. Its aim is to develop character, comradeship, discipline, and a secular outlook, the spirit of adventure and ideals of selfless service amongst young citizens. So the thing is that apart from the BTEC course, this course also you can choose which is going to run simultaneously. You do not have to give a lot of time, only particularly for few 10 to 20 days, some kind of camp is going to take place in the institute and you have to attend that camp. Okay. So what are the things that is going to happen in MCC? Briefly, I am going to discuss this thing. So in MCC, we are going to have in-house training in which we are going to give you the training over drill, weapon, Indian constitution, different types of diseases, their cure, map reading, shooting, and other miscellaneous things. So I hope everybody is aware of this drill thing. What is drill? So you have seen whatever army people are doing or the defense personnel they are doing, that is left, right, and there are many other things that also take place inside drill. So these things you will be taught. Why they have been taught? Because to instill a sense of discipline in all of you. Then some kind of weapon will be also discussed, and you will be they are going to tell you how the weapons are going to run, particularly 7.62 millimeter SLR. You are going to see, you have to open, you have to operate that weapon. Then Indian constitution, which is very important thing, even one small course is also there in your academic courses about this Indian constitution. So everybody has to know what is all about in Indian constitution. Then different diseases, their cure. Then in map reading, they are going to discuss the application of compass, how using the compass you can detect at which location you are, at which location you have to go. And in shooting, you know, they are going to taught you the firing thing. One of our student is going next month in Uttar Pradesh for this shooting competition also. Apart from that in-house training, we are going to have some camp training, like annual training camp, combined annual training camp. Okay, so this camp is presently going on at Tamluk, where your seniors are attending the camp. Then another camp is centrally organized camp. These camps are generally organized through the center, particularly from Delhi. Annual training camp are organized from the local battalion under which we are enrolled. So our college are enrolled under 55 Bengal Battalion, Tamluk. Then annual Republic Day camp will be there, Prime Minister rally will be there, attachment training, social service and community development, youth exchange program, adventure-based learning and sports. So what are these things? Just briefly, one by one, we are going to see. So annual training camp, I have told you, they are being conducted within the state and under the representative of NCC Directorate. So we are under West Bengal and Sikkim NCC Directorate. Okay. Then centrally organized camp will be a camp where a student or cadet from all over India will be participating. And these camps are national integration camps, then national special national integration camps. Okay, so previously they have been held at Jammu and Kashmir, then North East region, Lakshadweep, Port Blair, all these locations. Now, due to Corona, since last 2 years, we are not going to conduct this kind of camp. Only the local, that is your annual training camp, that is going on. Then leadership camp is there. A total of 1350 cadets attend to focus the personality development. They are going to teach you about personality development, leadership skill, and orientation for induction into the armed forces. So how you are going to join armed forces, what are the credit, what is the merit you are going to get by being an NCC cadet, these things will be taught under this leadership camp. Then Thal Sainik camp is also there. This is conducted at headquarter DGCC camp. Then it is also conducted at Parade Ground, Delhi every year. Okay. I hope this everybody is aware, annual Republic Day camp. This camp is being organized every year on 26th January particularly, and the training goes up from 1st January to 29th January. And throughout the country, 2070 selected NCC candidates are going to participate in it. Okay, so you are going to have the opportunity to meet Prime Minister and Vice President also in this Republic Day camp. Then after the Republic Day camp, that is on 26th January, on 28th January, we are going to have Prime Minister rally, where the NCC cadets, they are going to honor the Prime Minister of our country. Okay. Then there are few attachment training. Attachment training means you will be sent to some armed forces unit, like some infantry battalion, or particular girls will be sent to some Indian military academy or some officers training academy, or maybe some military hospitals also. There you are going to stay with the armed forces, and there you are going to learn the actual practical things that do happen at those places. Then this is one is very important, youth exchange program. So every year from different countries, our NCC cadets are going to get exchanged. They will go to their country to participate in some kind of program, and the other country people, they are going to, or cadets, they will be coming here. Okay, so this kind of youth exchange program also has been conducted from throughout the country. Maximum 20 to 25 students or NCC cadets are been selected, and they will be sent for this youth exchange program. This youth exchange program do held, last year it was held at Russia. Then there are some adventure-based learning in which you are going to have some mountaineering expeditions, all India trekking expeditions, camel safari, para sailing, para basic course, then sailing expedition, and cycle and motorcycle rally. All these are not taking place since last 2 years due to Corona. So unless and until this Corona is going to extreme from our country, these are not going to continue. Okay, so before Corona, everything was taking place. Now, similarly, sports is also there in NCC, where we are going to have one particular team which is going to represent NCC. So these teams are going to participate in national level events like Subroto Cup, Nehru Cup, and national shootings also. So I have told you that one of your senior is going for this national shooting competition next month. Now what you are going to get? So after you are going to complete this 3 year course, the after second year, you are going to get the B certificate. Okay, so there will be one exam which will be conducted, and if you are going to pass that exam, you will get the first certificate of NCC, that is your B certificate. And in the third year, again, there will be one final exam, and if you are going to pass, you are going to get the C certificate. So this C certificate is very important. Okay, so what is the important? So if you are going to have this C certificate, then 32 vacancies in every regular course of Indian Military Academy are reserved for NCC C certificate holders who have passed the CDS and have been declared successful by the Service Selection Board. Okay, so you are going to have a distinct advantage during training, because you are going to have one separate type of merit list, which will be prepared only for NCC cadets with C certificate. Then special entry scheme is also there for technical and non-technical also. Okay, and this is only for your national NCC cadets who are going to have C certificate. So if you are going to pass, there will be direct interview, there will be no written exam. So if you are going to pass, you will be deputed for training at Officer Training Academy, Chennai. Then in Navy, any kind of whatever exam they are taking for the graduate people, okay, like technical or non-technical, in those, for every course, there will be 6 NCC cadet whose list will be reserved. Okay, so also 2 year age relaxation will be there for NCC certificate holder. Here also you do not have to give any kind of written exam, direct you can go for interview. Then in Indian Air Force, 10% in any of the recruitment is been reserved for the NCC cadet. Again here you do not have to appear for any UPSC exam. Okay, directly you have to go for interview, that is Service Selection Board. Then paramilitary forces, there will be some written exam where you are going to get 2 to 10 bonus marks. Then some of the industries are also there, like Reliance is there, which are looking for NCC cadet having C certificate, and these jobs will be related with the field of security. And in the state government also, for state government public service commission, they are also some of the state, they are giving 5 to 10 or 20, something like this, marks, extra marks if you are a NCC C certificate holder. Now these are some of the training that has been held in our college, okay, before Corona. So these are your seniors who are attending these, who are NCC cadet, and they were attending the course. So if you can see, this is your first year hostel. In front of your first year hostel, these are, they were in the first year when this training was going on. So the classroom training is also there, when the people, army people will be coming and they will be training you for each leadership quality, for other extracurricular activities, for weapon training, map reading, everything. And this was the camp which was held in our college. That is your annual training camp. So this was the firing training that was been held. This is also in our college, also only in front of the first year hostel. Now these are your senior who are presently today also, they are attending the camp that is taking place at Tamluk College. And if you can see, they have already, your senior has already appeared for the B certificate exam, and now they are going for C certificate exam. So we are going to have our first batch of C certificate NCC pass out student in next year. These are all your seniors who are attending the camp. So this is all about NCC. So one more thing, you are going to have one mandatory additional requirement, MAR. In MAR, you have to show some extracurricular activity. For each of the extracurricular activity, you will be given some marks. Okay, and 25 marks should you have to get yearly. So even if you are attending this NCC, you are going to get some extracurricular marks.
So is it will be counted as more activities?
Yeah, there are many columns in under which there are some activity like drawing, painting is there, photography is there, then competition is there, poem, all these things is taking place in NCC. So they are, you will be getting some certificates also. You can show those certificate and you will get the marks. Okay.
That means if I take part in this program, then I will get 25 marks.
No. That depend how much activity you have done in NCC.
Okay, sir.
How can we join?
This is my contact number. This is my phone number. Whoever is interested, you can mail me or you can message me. Okay. So there will be means from the battalion, they will tell what will be the date of recruitment of NCC cadet. So maybe in the next month there will be first year cadet recruitment. So I will inform you the date. And if you are interested, you can send me the names now also. Okay. So when they will tell the date, then I will call you all. If you have any other doubt. No query, then this was all about NCC.
Sir. Sir, if I join in NCC, then have I pay any extra charges?
No, nothing. This is all totally free of cost.
Sir, is there any advantages to those students who are belong to means scouts and guides?
Yeah, definitely. When this recruitment will be done for the first year, only 20 to 25 seats will be there. So they will be coming and they will be recruiting. So those who already have this kind of like scouts and this thing, they will be recruited first.
Sir, I have completed my Tritiya Sopan, so any advantages?
The advantages will be there that you will be recruited. It is not that whoever is interested will get NCC. Okay, because the seats are only 20 to 25. That the number of seats will be given by battalion. So this year seat, I don't know how much they are going to give. Last year only 25 seats were given to us.
Okay, sir.
And the number of students, those who have shown the interest, it was almost 45. So I have to remove the 20 students from that list.
Okay, sir. Okay.
So in that case, you will get the advantage.
Okay, sir.
Array means nobody need any kind of A certificate. Okay, once you will join the institute, suddenly you have to appear after 1 year for B certificate, and after that B certificate you have to appear for C certificate. Okay, so A certificate is not required at all.
Sir, how they shortlist the name in the first NCC cadre?
Last
year, which is 25 last year.
The first time that they have shortlisted, they have given one paper, they have taken some writing, means one topic was given. But there are many things that they check when they are going to select, like some physical activity also they have done. But this year, I don't think there will be any kind of physical activity due to Corona. So only online recruitment will be done. So online, maybe some kind of interview, small interview, or like this will be taking place.
Thank you, sir. I got it.
Somebody is asking when will it start? When you the college? No, it is not like that. If college is closed, even then, online activities will go on. Online activities like some classes will be taken by them weekly, one or two class. Maybe I will be taking your classes. Okay. So weekly two period will be given to you, maybe on Sunday or Saturday or Monday, whenever you are going to have some free time apart from academic. So during that time, some theory classes will be done, and some competition also, like drawing, painting, whatever activity is being done in the battalion, that you have to participate. And physical activity will be done only during the camp. Okay. Until the college opens. Any other question?
Sir, have I any injured part in my body? Can I join NCC camp?
That you have to talk to me personally. You can call me later. I have shown you my phone number. I have shown you the email ID. There are some relaxations. Okay, so I will tell you what are the relaxation. Then you can apply.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay, DKM sir, should I stop? Hello. Hello, DKM sir.
Thank you, Aditya sir.
Okay.
I hope that you have shared all this information, not only for the MAR, but also for it's helpful for the recruitment. So I have not seen that you have missed anything. So definitely it will help you for the all the students, but the seat is limited. This is the thing, but you have to try for this thing. If it is possible, definitely it will help you. So let us go for the next program. So this is very important. In the last day, as we have told, that we'll go some extracurricular activities, definitely in virtual mode, and we'll see some activities of your trades. Just wait some time, we'll come. So Mr. Madam is here. Perhaps no, okay. DG sir, please.
DKM sir, just join. Okay, can I start now? DKM sir.
Yes, yes.
Can I start now?
Yes, yes. We start presentation.
Okay.
Very good morning to all of
it's
you.
Okay.
Namaskar to all my respected teachers and sincere love to all my batchmates.
It's okay.
I am Sutama Sarkar, first year student of Computer Science and Engineering Department. We are grateful for giving us the opportunity to conduct this program organized by the induction cell of our college. Let's make this morning more shining and joyful together.
Thank you, Sutama, for your hearty welcome. Jara, amader ondhokate ke aloi niye ashen. তারাই আমাদের আমি রোহিত ধারা ইনফরমেশন টেকনোলজি ডিপার্টমেন্ট থেকে শিক্ষকদের শ্রদ্ধা জ্ঞাপন আর তুলে ধরলাম গুরু বন্দনা পরিবেশনা ইলেকট্রনিক্স অ্যান্ড কমিউনিকেশন ইঞ্জিনিয়ারিং ডিপার্টমেন্টের শ্রী আদিতা দেব
গুরুর ব্রহ্মা নমস্কার, কবি বীরেন্দ্র চট্টোপাধ্যায়ের কবিতা কালো বস্তির পাঁচালী। কালো রাত কাটে না কাটে না, এত ডাকি রোদ্দুর এই পথে হাঁটে না, ঘরে না মাঠে না। সূর্যি ঠাকুর শোনো, সূর্যি ঠাকুর গো, আমাদের খোকা খোকু তোমারও কি পর গো। মা গো, এত ডাকি খিদের দেবতাটাকে, বেশি নয় যেন দুবেলা দুমুঠো নুন মাখা ভাত রাখে। তুই আর আমি দুঃখ ভুলবো, ভুলবো পেটের জ্বালা, খিদের দেবতা সে কি একেবারে কালা। বাছারে আমরা অচ্ছ, তাই যেভাবে যতই ডাকো কোনো দেবতাই পস্তিতে আসে না কো। আয় রোদ্দুর আয়, আয় আমাদের ন্যাংটা খুকুরে নোংরা বিছানায়, আয় রোদ্দুর বস্তিতে আদমরা ওই খুকুর ঠোঁটে একটু চুমুর স্বস্তি দে। আয় লক্ষ্মী আয় রে সোনা, এইটুকুতে চাঁদ যাবে না। আয় রোদ্দুর আয়, দারুণ শীতে খুকুমোদের ঠান্ডা হয়ে যায়, আয় রে শীত মারিয়ে ফয়ের জুজু ডাইনি বুড়ির চুল ধরে দে তাড়িয়ে। আয় লক্ষ্মী আয় রে সোনা, রাত গেলে কি ভোর হবে না। শূন্য উঠান, শূন্য মাচা, শূন্য ভাড়ার ঘর, এমন দিনে বাছারে তোর এ কোন কঠিন জ্বর। এর ছাঁটা ওর লাঠি খেয়ে বেড়েছিস তুই ছেলে, বাঁচবি কি তুই এ জ্বরেও উপসে দিন গেলে। বৃষ্টি পরে টাপুর টুপুর, আমি কি তোর মা, চোখের চলে খড় ভেসে যায় তাপ তো কমে না ক্ষুধার আগুন দাও 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 কান্না ভেজা খড়ে মায়ের কোলে দুধের শিশু দুধ ছাড়া আজ মরে বাইরে বাতাস আছড়ে পড়ে আমি কি তোর মা ছাটা শৈলা লাঠি শৈলা কি জন্য শোনা
থ্যাংক ইউ সুতমা This is Arijit Pal from the Department of Computer Science and Engineering. Now let's move on to our next dance performance. Upama Chatterjee from the Department of Computer Science and Engineering is presenting an amazing dance performance on the song Amar Mukti Aloy Aloy.
Thanks, Upama, for your beautiful dance. I would like to request Abra Rai to perform a recitation.
Kobiguru Rabindranath Thakurer lekha Mrityunjay Dur hote bhebechhinu mone Dur jay nirday tumi Kande bithi tomar shashu Tumi bithishikha Dukhir bidinno bokkhe jale tabo Leli hansika Dokhin hater sel uthechi Jharer megho pani শেথা হতে বজ্র টেনে ভয়ে ভয়ে এসেছিনু দুরু দুরু বুকে তোমার সম্মুখে তোমার ভুকুটি ভঙ্গে আসঙ্গিল তরণ্য উৎপাত নামিল আঘাত পাঁজর উঠিল কেঁপে বক্ষে হাত চেপে শুধালেন আরো কিছু আছে নাকি আছে বা কি এই মাত্র আর কিছু নয় ভেঙে গেল যখন উত্তত ছিল তোমার অশনি তোমারে আমার চেয়ে বড় বলে নিয়েছিল কাল তোমার আঘাত সাথে নেমে এলে তুমি যেথা মোর আপনার ছোট হয়ে গেছো আজ আমার টুটিল সব লাজ যত বড় হও তুমি তো মৃত্যুর চেয়ে বড় নও আমি মৃত্যুর চেয়ে বড় এই শেষ কথা বলি যাবো আমি চলে নমস্কার
Everybody has unique interest. Presenting Rajushi Shamanto from Electronics and Communication Engineering Department to present her uniqueness on making a miniature. Thank you.
Today we have Sumedha Roy from Computer Science and Engineering Department for yoga.
Nilanjana Samanto, Computer Science and Engineering Department, is presenting another beautiful dance performance on the song Sonali Sonali.
Sonal Sonal Balika, Radha Kusuma Balika. Sonal Sonal Balika, Radha Kusuma Balika. Kunj Kunj Phirano Sakhi. कुंज फेर सखी श्याम चंद्र नागिरे राख कुसुम मालिका
Let's move on to our next dance performance. Ankita Saha, Computer Science and Engineering Department, is presenting a mesmerizing dance performance on the song Kharmore Pardesiya.
Raghukul Reet Sada Chaliya
Coronavirus. Kanchan Mohammad Shamsuddin. Danga noy, hingsha noy, nei kono maramari, তবু দেখি বিশ্বজুড়ে কারফু হয়েছে জারি। স্কুল কলেজ দোকান বাড়ি সব হয়েছে বন্ধ। বাতাসে ভাইরাস বইছে শুধু আতঙ্কের গন্ধ। পরাক্রমী মানব জাতি মুখ ঢেকেছে মুখোশে, এই বুঝি গেল চলে প্রাণটা এক নিমেষে। বাঁচতে হলে বারে বারে হাতটা ধোয়া চাই, বিজ্ঞানীরাই বলছে আজ হতে সূচি বাই। হাত রেখো না আর হাতে, নিষেধ করমর্দন, নমস্কারেই জানাতে হবে এখন অভিবাদন। নামছে শেয়ার করছে টাকা, ব্যবসা উঠছে লাটে, যুদ্ধ লড়াই করতে গিয়ে টান পড়েছে গাঁটে। টেলিফোনে কান পাতলে পরে দিচ্ছে হাঁচি কাশি, অদৃশ্য দানব ভয়ে কাঁপছে বিশ্ববাসী। জনগণ হিস্টেরিয়া, যেও না কর ভিড়ে, রবির কথাই সত্যি হলো একলা চলরে। ঘুচে গেছে সব আস্ফালন শ্রেষ্ঠ হওয়ার বড়াই, একলা মানুষ লড়ছে আজই বেঁচে থাকার লড়াই। আসবে কবে, আসবে কবে সুদিন ফিরে, অপেক্ষা শুধু তারই। শিক্ষা কি কিছু দিয়ে গেল করোনা মহামারী? সদা সতর্ক থাকুন, সরকারি সমস্ত নিয়ম মেনে চলুন, সুস্থ থাকুন, ভালো থাকুন।
পারফর্মিং অনুভবশীল ফ্রম কম্পিউটার সায়েন্স অ্যান্ড ইঞ্জিনিয়ারিং ডিপার্টমেন্ট ফর প্লেইং তবলা।
We started with a spiritual aura and we are going to end with it too. So now calling Kasturi Chatterjee from Computer Science and Engineering Department to perform on Aigiri Nandan.
thank you, Kasturi, for your wonderful performance.
Thank you all the professors for being a part of our first induction program.
We are extremely grateful to Sharmishtha Bose Madam
for her constant cooperation with us.
We offer our gratitude to our three seniors, Pallu Bhajra Dada, Tridim Mal Dada and Shrestha Sorgadvi for cooperating with us and guiding us till the last moment.
With all of your due permission, we now conclude this program. Thank you for being with us.
So, Mr. Ma'am, you are requested to tell something. Hello, so Mr. Ma'am. So, Mr. Ma'am, yes, yes. Yes, you are visible. You are muted. Madam, you are muted. Madam, you are muted. Madam, unmute yourself. So, Mr. Ma'am, unmute yourself. So, Mr. Ma'am,
I think some problem arises. Due to this reason, he is not possible. Okay.
Is it okay?
Okay.
Good morning to everybody. Good morning, DK sir. Good morning, DG sir. Good morning, my dear colleagues. And also, good morning, my dear students. The first year students, this is your first performance. And you have done a wonderful job. And also, I want to thank my third year students, Pallav, Shrestha, and Tridi, who have worked a lot to guide our first year students. Now it is the time to announce who everybody has done well, but I have to choose among you whose performance is the best performance. That's why I'm grading. First is Tabla Anubhav Shil. Hello, Anubhav, are you present? Hello. First is Anubhav Shil, CAC. Roll number 85.
Congratulations, Anubhav. Are you there?
Are you there, Anubhav?
Not.
Can you switch on your video? Hello? Second is Shutama Sarkar, CAC 81. Shutama? Most probably you have done the recitation, isn't it, Shutama? Shutama, are you present? Shutama, are you present?
Also, she is not there. Yeah, ma'am.
And third is Dance Upama Chatterjee, Amar Mukti Aloy Aloy, CAC roll number 14.
Yes, madam. I'm present here.
Are you present?
Yes, Sutama? Ma'am.
Congratulations, Sutama, for ma'am, your fantastic performance.
And fourth position, it is going to Rituporna Mukherjee, instrumentation, roll number 50. And
yes, ma'am.
Radushi Shamunto, EC 27, for miniature art. Okay, now I request the students to say few words about your experience which you have, which you think you during the entire induction program, how you have enjoyed, how you have motivated, and about your performance, you can say few words. Hello, Sutoma, are you present?
Madam, Sutoma, YouTube link is here.
Hello?
Okay. Tell Poma to join through Google Meet because it is now it is not full. Okay, any other?
DKM say most probably they is their mic is off or on?
Many of them have joined through YouTube link, that's why they are unable to talk. But those who have joined through Google Meet, if you want to say something about this then program.
I'm seeing Ritubhavna Mukherjee, he has joined.
Hello, ma'am.
So it is.
If anyone is interested, please tell something.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes. Put on your video.
Anubhav Steel, love the performance this few minutes earlier. Thank you, ma'am, for so much. I am here. Thank you, Sharmishta, ma'am, and thank you, Dilip, sir. And thank you, Deepak sir, also. And thank you so much for this opportunity for me to perform here. And many of them, I would like to thank the whole college team for selecting me to perform here. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Any other?
Ma'am.
DKM sir, you please continue.
So Upama.
Yes, sir.
Upama Chatterjee, you want to say something?
Yes, sir.
Please say. Okay.
Myself, Upama Chatterjee from Computer Science and Engineering Department, my roll number is AAC21014. I'm very glad to be a part of this. It's my first induction program, and I'm very glad to be a part of this, and especially I would like to thank Professor Dr. Sharmishta Bose Madam for giving me this opportunity, and especially I'd like to thank my three seniors, Pallo Bhajra Dada, Tridi Mal Dada, and Shrestha Sharkar Didi, for support me, because without their support I can't do it. So thank you all.
Hello. I am Sutama Sarkar.
Okay, it is audible. You continue, Sutama. Sutama, okay. You can continue.
Okay. I'm extremely sorry. I was joined on YouTube. So it's so much grateful for me for participate here. And it's very much blessing for me also. And thanks to SB ma'am and my seniors also for giving me this opportunity to participate here. And I'm so happy for being a member of this college.
Okay, thank you, Sutama. Or anybody want to share your views?
This is our concluding remarks.
Wait, madam is present.
Yes.
Madam.
Hello.
Yes, it is audible, madam. You can conclude.
Oh, okay.
Closing session. Okay, closing speech.
Okay, so we come to the conclusion of this wonderful induction program, online induction program. I'm sure that the students are feeling that they are now an integrated part of the college. It has been a pleasure having you all, and I think you have heard your teachers, you have seen your other friends participating. A special thank to the induction team, to Dr. Deepak Kumar Mondal, who has been the chairperson of this committee, to Dilip Kumar Gayan sir, who has also been hand-holding all these days, to Sharmishta Bose ma'am sir, who has also helped in organizing this beautiful program, and also a member of this induction committee. And I'm sure you've seen your other teachers, Aditya sir, the NCC, the NSS, Sheba Maiti ma'am, and you've got an idea of the wonderful, rich life we lead in the college. You've had online counseling, you've had values and ethics, universal human values, and we hope that you are going to enjoy the classes also, the teachers also. You shall be meeting very soon. Tomorrow is the foundation day in the college. So tomorrow we are not having the classes, but this is a very important announcement. Day after tomorrow, we are starting the first year classes. So have you heard it, the first year students? Yes? All of you?
Yes,
ma'am. That day after tomorrow, you must be excited that what are the classes you might be having. So you will get to know about the syllabus and you will start with the class. So with this, we end the induction program, but this is not the end. This is the beginning of your journey in CMK. So thank you. With these words, it is over to you, Deepak sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
The closure of the program.
Thank you, ma'am.
And Gayan sir. Thank you.
Again, if anyone want to tell about this induction program, total induction program, not only this program, not only this co-curricular activity, throughout this program. If anyone is interested to tell your opinion about this induction program for 5 days, please come forward, unmute yourself and tell something.
Anyone from student side, please unmute yourselves. Just tell me what DKM sir told you. Just tell him about the induction program, 5 days induction program. Anybody?
So if there is no anything from your side, so initially at the beginning of induction program, we have told the objectives of this induction program. We hope somehow we have reached with some knowledges for which this program has been planned. Definitely day after tomorrow we will join in the classes. Accordingly you will get everything by the mail. Most probably you will get all the information via your mail. I repeat, those who have not activated yet now your college mail ID, you activate yourself with this mail ID, because throughout these 5 days I have tried to send your personal mail ID, but from tomorrow day, after tomorrow you will not get any information from your personal mail ID. You have to join through your college mail ID. If you have any problem, contact your HOD and activate your college mail ID. I hope from my side it's okay, excellent. All these things are excellent. All the lectures, all the students, those who have performed in many things. Now, Digi sir, if you want to tell something to the students for closing this program.
Okay, actually, this is the wonderful experience by the student. Also, actually, this is the second time we are organizing the induction program in online. So this way we try to accommodate all these things so that student can get some flavor about the college, not only college, what happened, things are happening nowadays. So, and they also learn about the different things. All these things we are try to cover in these 5 days. So student get enriched the knowledge from these 5 days. Again, if they have any doubt or any confusions regarding, they can contact their HODs or mentor, so they will guide them to solve the problems. Okay, thank you DKM sir. Nothing we thank can conclude you. Here
thank you Nirakuna ma'am, Digi sir, Sunista ma'am for joining in this coordination of this program. So thank you the students for joining this program. We are leaving now.
DKM sir, another thing I want to say. Is there any feedback link are you create?
No. So you still given to your college mail.
Okay, we will say, actually students, we will send a actually feedback link will be sent to your mail. Everybody, all those are attending the induction program in these 5 days, everybody fill this feedback form. This will actually help us to enrich the program, that if you have having some suggestions, we try to incorporate in this actually event next time. Okay, so all our advice, what link we will send to your college mail, everybody fill up this link, feedback link. Okay.
Okay, sir, thank you.
Okay, sir. Sir, sir, when will be the class arrive?
Class, day after tomorrow. It will start day after tomorrow. Informations will go through your college mail ID. You'll get the timetable to your college mail ID. Okay.
From tomorrow, the classes will be start.
Day after tomorrow.
Oh, day after tomorrow. Okay, sir.
Sir, and the PDF of MAC and MOCS.
Okay. I will send you what is the guidelines, everything I will send you. But every time you have to access your college mail. Okay, we are not making any communication. We are not making any communication with personal mail ID. Okay. And if some of your friends do not receive the college mail ID, you just talk to them that they must contact with the HODs. So that actually there is a two-step verification is there in the mail. You have to verify your mail ID. Otherwise, you cannot access the mail ID. Okay. Sayan, I will send you all these documents related to MOOCs and MAR.
Okay, sir. Thank you.